Hey everybody, it's Invicta, and it's time for another Air Amazing here on the channel. Today I'm going to be playing as Cho'Gath, and needless to say, expectations could not be any lower for this game. I know that's a terrible note to start off with, but take a look at the team that we have. We've got Cho'Gath, Renekton, Master Yi, Poppy, and Shyvana taking on Elise, Rumble, Amumu, Karma, and Syndra. Now, that may not sound like all that bad, but none of us are actually ranged champions. For those of you who are unfamiliar with all these champions here. So, I'm hoping for the best. I'm trying to remain positive. I also prefer to be a realist and have realistic expectations. And right now, they're not good. I have to be completely honest. We're not exactly at the peak of my expectation level. Especially the fact that I haven't played Cho'Gath in a while. It's been a long, long time since I played Cho'Gath. I believe that Cho'Gath was like number 4, number 5 on Air Amazing. I'm actually, you know what? I'm gonna take a look right now because I honestly don't remember. I know that Cho'Gath was one of the earliest Air Amazings that we did. And by the way, you may see the FPS tank here because I'm alt tabbed. I'm genuinely curious. When was the first Cho'Gath appearance? Okay, so it's been a little bit longer than that. Well, I can't find it now. Okay, so I was thinking of Renekton. Renekton was like number 5. That's right. I need to refresh myself with Cho'Gath's ability. Rupture is the knockup. W is the silence. E is the, let's see. Spice Growth is the basic text. Launch. All right, so yeah, so that's. I think it's on. I think that one's on. Like, it's almost a passive. Almost. I don't quite remember. It's been a long time since I played Cho'Gath, but that way. So I might get hit by that cocoon. So yeah, so after the last Air Amazing a couple of days ago, like I said, we're not. We're going to be realistic here. We're not going to. We're not going to look at the moon and aim for the clouds or whatever that saying's called. I'm pretty sure I just made that up, but I'm just going to pretend I didn't. And. Like I said, we're going to give it our the old college try here. You knock up a Amumu, there's karma. But again, without any ranged DPS, I don't have high hopes. There's Mr. White Blues there on Poppy. I am going to silence Rumble. Unfortunately, I missed the knockup. We're just getting picked apart right now by the enemy team, which, like I said, is kind of expected right now. I mean, the one that we really have to worry about is Elise. Elise is going to be nightmarish, and Syndra as well, and Karma. It's just a bad matchup all around. We're gonna give it our best though. We're certainly gonna try. I don't know what did so much damage to me there. I think it may have been one of the bloodlings, broodlings, whatever. Whatever Elise has, it's one of those spire things. Combination with Karma. So, I'm going to be building tanky, somewhat tanky on Cho'Gath. Even though, like, pretty much all of our characters can build tanky outside of Master Yi. It might be wiser for me to go a little bit more damage oriented, but again, I think it would be funny if we all just went tanky. I think that would be quite funny. So I'm going to level up Scream first, and the reason why I want to do that is because I have a feeling I'm going to find myself in the middle of every match, of every, like, huge fight, I should say, and I just want to do as much damage as possible. So I am going to get the silence off here and try to do as much as we can. Nope, going to get taken out by Elise. Can we get Syndra? Nope. Can we get anyone? Nope. Can we at least get one? Nope. All right. Good start. So 4-0 after 4 minutes. Team Invicta is we're acting in Team Invicta fashion. I don't think I've ever seen Cho'Gath as small as he is right now. Hey, it's not the size that counts. It's the size of the fight in the Cho'Gath that matters. Whatever that old t-shirt said. Again, Again, I need to get a really solid Feral Scream. That's what it's called. I think I said Psychic Scream. And can we knock up somebody? Anybody? Can we get a kill? Yes, indeed, we get a kill, finally. Pretty sure that was a kill steal, that's right. And Amumu trying to get away from everyone. I might be able to knock two of them up here. One more scream, I am taken down. There we go. So I was able to get Rumble there. And then Karma did her thing. And somehow we lost the entire team. Triple kill for Elise, and that's not what we really wanted to happen. Although somehow Shyvana got the shutdown. I guess it was from the turret, but Elise now 6-1. Surprisingly, I came away with two kills out of that. Karma going to try to execute herself. Not going to happen. Way too much creep interference. Alright, so we finally get Feast. Now, what's nice about Feast is that it does true damage. It deals true damage. Oh my god! What just happened? I just got like three shot from people. That was Karma, Elise, and Amumu. Alright, well, I guess tankiness would be a good thing. So, we didn't kill anybody. We sure tried, but didn't quite work out. I forgot to buy, that's alright. I don't think it really matters in this game as it's already 4-13. Yep, we're doing the good old Team Invicta stride here. We're in the moment. We're in the groove, so to speak. I don't know why I keep toggling off my E, but does it really matter if I toggle off my E? I think I'm supposed to be using Feast to. I honestly don't remember how to play Cho'Gath. I can't believe I jumped into that cocoon. So, yeah. I mean, after all the killing that's gone on, like I said, it's surprising that we still have a turret at this point. And, oh, one bandage toss, and Cho'Gath is dead. Cho'Gath needs to not be the initiation here. I feel like Renekton and Poppy need to be initiating. So yeah, 16-5. It's going pretty good. I guess I am gonna build Cho'Gath tanky. Poppy, nope. 17-5. All right, team, we got this. We got this. Easy peasy. But again, I can't even act like I'm surprised because I pretty much saw this one happening from a mile away. Mana gets the shutdown. There we do, finally get the Feast. Cho'Gath hungers. Someone ignite me? I think we'll go with Vorpal Spikes, that's fine. Like I said, we're keeping ourselves in realistic check here. Again, we don't want to aim too high, pipe dream and all. I think we should start with small goals in this game. I think the first goal should be damaging their turret. That will be our first goal here. And Shyvana unknowingly just saved Rumble's life. And yep. So Shyvana just saved Rumble, and that was the opposite of good. I don't want to call it bad, but let's just say that it wasn't good. They could have easily killed Rumble there, but unfortunately Shyvana's Dragon Leap, whatever that is, just pushed him back, and fortunately saved his life. Fortunately for him, unfortunately for us, Rumble ended up getting a double kill out of that. So it's 8-22. We're going very well. Have we damaged the turret yet? Yes, but I think that was creep damage. All right. So if we can get a confirmed champion basic attack on the enemy's turret, we're going to call that a victory. Doesn't matter what happens afterwards. It doesn't matter how bad we lose this game, because we've already determined that this game was a loss from the loading screen. We already knew that. So it's the little things. It's the little things that matter in life. You can't worry about not getting what you want when setting your expectations too high. That's not the way to do things, in my opinion. Rumble on a killing spree, and I'm just going to barrel scream and get killed by a Moo Moo. All right. Well, we ended up getting a kill out of it. Renekton was able to kill Elise there, so that's good. Let's see. How much? Did I have a lot of AD? It's mostly AP. Mostly AP. So hopefully the game isn't over by then, I might be able to get a spirit massage. I should probably be using Peace more as well. I mean, his Feast costs 100 mana, and I remember I can use that on Creep. There we go. I couldn't remember how Cho'Gath gets his stacks. But now I have. I've pulled it. It's all coming back to me. Going to silence them all here. We are going to get a kill on Syndra. Actually get a kill on Rumble as well. Where's Elise going to fall? There she is. And where's my team going? Where are you guys going? We had the advantage going into that. Apparently Team Invicta didn't feel like fighting. All right. Have we gotten any more damage on their turret? No. It's good. So 1 second left on Feast. I have nothing to feast on. Well, it didn't heal me for as much as I was expecting. I was hoping for more of a little bit of a heal than that. So Yi finally shuts down Elise, almost dying in the process. It's all right. We're on the comeback here. The goal, the dream is alive. I need to have one confirmed champion basic attack on the turret, and then we can call this one a win. I believe that the team can do it. I believe that our team has the ability to do it if they believe. I believe in my team. I think we can do it. I just need one confirmed basic attack from a champion. That's all I want. So 14 to 31, there's been 45 kills in 12 minutes, which that number feels like it's high. And I will admit that I have not been as liberal as I should have been with these ruptures. What do we call it? Rupture, yeah. Just gonna heal everyone because hell, why not at this point? Master Yi going in, and I am going to see if I can silence somebody. Amumu is not the one that we should be going after, team. Amumu is pretty much the only target that we should be going after. And yeah, we're not going to make it. Oh, I was able to get a kill out of that somehow. I was able to get a triple kill out of that. Well, that was surprising. I'm going to consider all those kill steals because I felt like I wasn't in control of my actions at that point. I didn't even get to use Feast. Feast was down for most of that fight up till the very end. We almost wiped them. We have a chance to do a basic attack here. Oh, is this it? Could this be it? Can we get a confirmed basic attack on the enemy's turret? That isn't creep. Well, the enemy team is—they're rezzed and waiting. I'm gonna bum rush it. Well, maybe not. They have too much of their team there. All right. Oh, the dream is still dead. I can't believe that rupture didn't knock anyone up. dream is dead. The dream is dead, but not over. Let's put it that way. It can be resurrected. If we believe. I still think our team has it in us. You hit Rupture there. I think I'm pretty sure they hit both Rumble and Karma in there. Poppy just gonna go for it. Again, Elise isn't the best target. Oh my god, just forget it. I don't even know. That's not even worth looking at. I think mostly that was Rumble. So, again, Elise isn't really the best target. I don't think we should be focusing her. I think we should be going for more of a Syndra variety. And there's another ace, so it's 20 to 41 after 15 and a half minutes. Let's see here. Yeah, we'll get some more. We'll get some more magic resist. We'll be tanky chaff. I don't know what chanky chaff is. I'm just gonna say it. It's like Lanky Kong, except it's tanky chaff. Able to land that on Elise there. She's forced to repel away. I am going to get the feast on Elise. And he gets a kill. Oh my gosh, can we do it? Can we do it? It's only Syndra. We can do it, team. We can do it. The dream is realized. It's renewed. We just need a basic attack. I'm going for it. I don't care. Screw the creep. I'm going for it. Yes, we did it. We did it, team. The basic attack on the turret. We have done it. The dream has been realized. Nothing else matters in this game anymore. We got a confirmed champion basic attack on the tier 1 turret. We did it, team. Now we can finish losing this game. But all joking aside, though, the composition of our team in this ARAM is just dreadful. That is classic Sinvicta luck right there. Going to try to get out as fast as I can. There's Shyvana again, almost saving Elise. And oh, that wasn't enough to kill. I can't believe that didn't kill Elise there. Look at that. Look how low she is. She had less than 40 hit points. Oh well. At least we got the dream was realized. We got one confirmed basic attack on the enemy outer turret. And that's all we can really hope for. Thank you for watching, everyone. I hope you enjoyed this eye-opening, enlightening, air-amazing Team Sinvicta showing you how it's done. Hopefully the next air-amazing goes better than it has been in the past couple of episodes. Gotta say, it's been less than stellar. But you can't you can't say that we didn't try. I think you can say a lot of things about our team, but one thing you can't say is you can't say that we didn't at least try. I think in the end that's all that matters. Even though you won't win any prizes for trying, but you'll get a bunch of sympathy golf claps. I think that's about all you can get. But hey, that's better than nothing. All right, we'll take them as we get them. I'll take a bunch of sympathy golf claps if it means that we don't have to worry about stunned, awkward silence. Land the Rupture, doing zero damage on Amumu, literally. And Rumble's ult is going to pick us apart here. Again, Shyvana needs to stop doing that. I really wish Jorlex would stop doing that. So much damage on Rumble, and then he just pops like 10 barriers. So Rumble is indeed going to finally get taken out. But, yeah, that should do it, hopefully. It doesn't get much worse than this. It really doesn't. 78 kills in 18 and a half minutes. 19 minutes. So, yep, I'm just going to end it there. Thank you for watching, everyone. Hopefully Team Sinvicta does better next time. Hopefully. We'll see. Until next time, so long, everybody. Why you know over, Aram? I already did my outro. You can't continue. There's a sorcery. Now we just have this weird, like, limbo thing going on with the game. It's kind of like time right now. It's a game that you know is over, but isn't. It's the equivalent of watching a TVT, where both players base race, they both lift up, and then everyone's just kind of sitting there, and the casters have to cover dead air. So they have playful banter back and forth. You know, Sean playfully jokes about his tie or something like that. Or would tell, like, an awkward joke. Or Artosis would start talking about, like, the lunch he had the other day. Like, I feel like that's where we are right now in this game. This game's not supposed to be continuing. I mean, the dream's already been realized here. We've already gotten the basic attack on the outer turret. So it's kind of like the game should just be over. World's worst rupture. Oh, apparently I used Feast on that super minion. Okay. Well, we're gonna just kind of chit chat here, and oh my god, are we gonna take out a turret? No. Curse the sad mummy going out and doing cuckoos of damage on everyone. And I was pretty sure I was in there somewhere, but I don't know if I was doing anything. So, yeah. So, I think that's going to do it. I hope it does. I hope everyone had a great day at work and school, if you were taking summer classes. Next time you go to the grocery store, remember, don't forget your to-do list, your shopping list. And always remember, this is something that a lot of people always forget. If you have a smartphone, there's no sense of writing stuff down. Open up your Notepad app and put your shopping list on there. That's Invicta's tip of the day. All right. Get me out of this game.